know what independence means. But one thing, even though Sierra Leone is a very small country in West Africa, but we too stand tall and say, no, we will not allow you after you have, you know, exploit our fathers. Then we that are coming up, we need to be independent for us not to go back for what you have done to our father. So in that regard, Sierra Leone, with people who have the zest, say, oh, if there is need, there is now time for us to have independence, they go for it. And we're going to learn about that. But before that, let me just give you an helicopter view of how it comes about. Because after the First World War, there are constitutional developments across the world. And you observe that there are a lot of organizations that were formed. One among them, you have the League of Nations, United Nations, and the rest of it, to see how best they can curb the issue of war among states. In that regard, the Second World War also came up. What happened, you see, the countries who are colonizing, you know, Africa, these are the very countries that engage in these wars. So in that regard, they stretch. And at that time, they have been, you know, occupying some other countries all across West Africa, all across Africa, to show their political prowess. I hope you know what I mean. Which means, the more country you conquer, the more powerful you become among your counterpart states, if I may say. So, unluckily for us, we are colonized by the British. And these people also play an active role in the First and Second World War. So after the Second World War, the British were hit very hard. And in that regard, they could not able to man the activities of the colony, of some of their colonies. Because one thing, they also colonized Nigeria. And Nigeria is a very, 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 very big country. So they also colonized Nigeria. And they could not able to man all their territories which they covered. So in that regard, they see the need for them to have governors. And these are people who serve as an intermediary between their colony and the crown, by meaning the queen, if I may say. So in that regard, they have this concession, allowance, to their colony to be ruled by themselves. So we have a strong man in this council by the name of Milton Magad. This is the man, Sir Milton Magad. That is why I decided to put the picture. So you cannot read about somebody, you don't know his face. This is the man. You see, he's a Mende Creole. And this woman, he said that to me, we are foreigners. We are not foreigners. I can say we are not foreigners. We are here and we continue to be here. And then also, in 1924, some of you know government. We have government for certain constitution. And that constitution creates a platform wherein the protectorate. What is protectorate? Who knows what is protectorate? The interior. That's very good. Protectorate means British protected area. Because you know we have the colony in Freetown. At that time, they don't concentrate in the interland. And our people are there. You know, so in that regard, in 1876, you see the British declare the interland as of 1896. Thank you very much, my brother. You know, I'm from Atomi. But anyway, in 1896, we see the British, you know, they declare the interland as their British protectorate area. Where even though they are here, but they also have command over there. Imagine these people, they are here, they are in the colony, and they also want to have penetrated their tentacle into your area. And indeed they succeed. But they meet some stringent measure by our local leader, like by Bouyens and others. Adding to that, during this constitution, the 1924 constitution, it gives priority to the protectorate, at least for them to have a representative in the colony, for them to be part of the governance system in the colony, since the white people are about to go. But imagine, we have some people who are very greedy, the Creole. Who believes that the Creole? The Creole are very greedy. You know that?
Yes.
Say, oh yeah. Okay. If that's no, if you say no, let me explain to you how the crew agreed. When this constitution says, let there be some people from the interland for them to be part of the legislative arms of government. There is one guy, Isaac William Johnson, who said no, they should not be part of us, they are uncivilized, and we are educated people, and we have learned from you. So if these people come in, automatically, they will bully us. And we don't want to do that, we have struggled a lot, because at that time, when the white men are here, they work with the Creole people, because they are a little bit educated. They said no, these people should not be part of us. But there is this man, who was Sam Mintimaga, you know, and this Mintimaga guy was a Creole man. Let me tell you this now. He's a Creole, but the problem with him is that his real name is supposed to be Tumboku Mentiga. That's the Creole name. His Creole name is Tumboku Mentiga. This Mintimaga you have heard about. But how does this guy get his name into my guy, Samuel to my guy? Because his stepfather is an ethnic Mende man, he's from the Mende country, and he's a leading protectorate politician that Samuel to my guy, stepfather, and also an educated man. And this Samuel to my guy was raised in the Mende kingdom, and for that reason, he's one of the protectorate elite. Because at that time, we have those who are in the colony who are educated, and this my guy comes from the Mende area, and he's very, very educated. And in that regard, this man, based on the knowledge he has acquired, he still needed to be part of the governance system of this country by then. This later, Sam Mintimaga's real name, I'm going through the scripts now, supposed to be Tumboku Mentiga, but he used that as a political scheme to win the minds of some tiny minority Creoles who are very greedy, to win them back. Oh, don't mind me because I'm from the Mende country, I'm still a Creole. They use the basic name to win some tiny minority of Creoles to be part of his team to go to England to get the independence to come to this country. Sam Mintimaga led the team, 1961. And before that, in November 1951, Sam Mintimaga oversaw the drafting of a new constitution which united is separate the colony and the protectorate to be together. And there he was finally appointed to be the first minister in this country. In May 1957, Sierra Leone held its first parliamentary election. And we have come about hearing about SNPP or whatsoever. And this man was elected as minister. But Mintimaga, in 1960, just like what I said, led the team. They went to Britain. But before that, the delegation this man took to Britain, we have people like Sir Albert Magai, his younger brother, John Kelly Fasmart. Some of us know, and learn about John Kelly Fasmart. He's not too. And he has died.